130 sheep, all in the barn, all very pregnant, all at once. So what happens when you want to go to bed, but nature has other ideas?
You got nice little feet. Okay.
Typically, sheep are some of the simplest animals to keep. They have big coats for the cold, they don't ruin a wet field, they just kind of get on with it. But there's one time of year they become the most demanding to farmers. Lambing time. And regardless of your circumstances, your setup, or how slick you can make it,
I'm not sure I'd want to be left alone with 130 sheep, especially if I've also got to be their emergency contact. And let's be honest, they wouldn't want that either.
For our farm, that's every year in April. One very condensed period where, as a farmer, you're on call. You're the emergency contact. And the entirety of your flock is pregnant.
Look at the belly on that.
And then has a lamb, or two ideally, sometimes three and maybe more. It all happens at once because they're all conceived at once. At least, that's the plan and the job of the rams. You put the ram in with the ladies at a specific time of year, and over the course of a few weeks, nature happens. Give it another 5 months, we arrive here, crunch time. Early mornings, full days, late nights. And it's this time that I find the most unusual, the one that as a farmer's son, I never thought a whole lot about before. It feels different in the barn to how I remember it, because when spring arrives like it has here, the days feel bright and bouncy, but the nights feel dramatic, eerily calm, almost peaceful, until something happens. There are so many things that Mum needs to constantly monitor down here. Everyone has food and water, ewes are okay, the lambs are okay, you know which lambs belong to which ewe, new lambs are staying in the pens with their mums, lambs have enough milk, mums are allowing lambs to have enough milk, whether any of the pregnant sheep are giving birth, and ultimately, whether they need your assistance. Because there's nothing worse than an animal needing help and the farmer not knowing.
It's okay.
But when you're handling 130 life events all on your own, it's impossible to be available all of the time. And that's seemingly the hardest part of lambing. Not the tiredness, not the amount of new life, not the pressure. It's the unknown and the eagerness to be available. Because when something happens, you better believe nothing is more important. And that really puts some things into perspective. One sheep needing your help in one moment. Nothing is more important than that. That's what I've noticed in Mum. For the majority of April, she's here, but her mind is down there. I suppose that's what makes a great shepherd. And the most remarkable thing about it is, for all Mum's special and wildly unique characteristics, the way she looks after her sheep is not one of them. This is how it's done by small farms all across the country. Hundreds of devoted farmers looking after their grassland, their flock of sheep. I feel so in awe of that dedication. And if you're wondering right now if you could do it, if you could handle the task of lambing, then I'll tell you right now, with all the conviction I have, to care this much, you have to be so invested and motivated by something deeper and more rooted. And for Mum, this is it.
How wonderful is that?
Green grass, healthy sheep, growing lambs. You don't have to drive very far to see a field like this in the UK. And when you do, spend a few seconds thinking about how special that is. Not because of that one farmer, field or lamb, but because this culture is alive, these fields are supporting life, and these lessons are being taught. I think that's worth celebrating. Wishing you a very happy spring from all of us here at the farm. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please leave us a comment. I'd love to hear from you. And consider subscribing. I'd love to show you what's next for the farm and our videos. Thanks so much. Take care.